why Ichigo doesn't come. Because if Solomon, if Nigla isn't playing Mindfall,
Just like, you know, you want to get that high, you know,
high octane game.
Yeah. High octane gameplay. So, of course, this is going to be loose to semis. Still a best of five, you know, offset versus on later.
Winner versus Ichigo.
Yep.
Alright, so, historically, this matchup is going to be what does it mean, like, you know, just slap each other? Yeah, back and forth.
Back and forth.
So, I think recently, our ladies had more wins versus LSA, but they were still being more players. Now, they both use different plays. They both play off, like, really good fun and they both have, like, really good fun. I think LSA, a good dead balance, especially for those how good I but LSA was really solid. We need obvious into the gas, it's just double on that, right? So,
I did not know that.
Yeah, no, if you were looking at the ICK game and you knew that, you could see who always, like, keeps their double jump. So that's impressive, and he works for it really well. Like, Hamlet take the first one really quickly. Especially if there's a 5-star. Good hit dodge. Yeah.
Right. there is no annoying grapples in this game.
No annoying Sharon at all. Okay, good edge guard reaches the top platform edge. So this strong, this stage is actually really strong. The LSA, I think. Yeah. A lot of strong back. Okay, Alex is gonna look to push his lead here. He's got a really good injury on just the intro then.
Putting Alistair, the game ahead.
Well played to Alistair that one. That was good.
Especially with that, you know, last off, just catching the
Yeah,
DI.
Yeah, no, that was a good trap as well, because I think the DH helps on the to put in the juggle situation. Forsbrown does have good tools to juggle, but Aclaren also has immense, good tools to land, but Aclaren has immense tools to juggle, right? So, yeah. Because she's such a distance demon with her. And it combos really well in the I'd say stomp, that's really good. Wow, those are really good levels. Just taking out every combo.
No,
that's usual base. It's how it needs to be, right?
So the regular move will be put on the cloud of gas. When he's got that cloud of gas, so it empowers his special?
It empowers one of his special things
about. Oh, okay.
So, down big, crush it now for the first time. So that's a tricky DI there, probably near frame perfect to live there, considering it's like up above of it. Because the survival DI on that is up and in, but then if you're DIing up and in, right, you get like
off the top of it.
Yeah, kind of. And think of that! No, absolutely!
I know, it's pretty enlightening, I gotta say.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't think of that myself.
Yeah, you're right. That mix up was very schmixy, as you said.
Yeah. Well, I think the thing is that and coverage at the same
exactly.
time. So while you get, you know, the mental damage of a mix-up, you're still just covering
optimal. It's still optimal.
It is actually optimal. Yeah, or optimal in some situations, you know. Still a slight creep, but it's probably a better option.
Truly a visionary, definitely.
Yeah, he knows what he's doing.
He's got the mental medicine. Alright, taking it to game 3 here. I'll say it's up 2 right now. They take it. Okay, so this stage is actually a very popular stage for Alistair. I don't know if it's like insane for Claren, but he really does like this stage.
That's how I play the stages in this game, because I don't know which one's good for my character, so I just, you know, I like this stage.
Oh, yeah.
Now, if you don't know how to build Optimal being comfortable with the next best friend.
That's true. That's actually how I learned, because I actually really like Optimal. I don't know if it's that much, right? So,
yeah, like, that's the whole thing I love. Being
that's good info. I definitely really think that. Because eventually, if you're comfortable with something, you don't have to think about it in the game, right?
Yeah, you know what you have to do, and even if you know it may be a little bit hard, if you're comfortable with a character or, you know, a stage, you're more likely to know counterplay or just.
I think, like, the general premise for a lot of people is one of the things as least possible that, like, you don't need to think about, right? Like, you don't need to think about what gun twist you have. You need to know, like, instinctively, you know, mother tongue and how to use it, right? And it's the same for stages, you know. If you know how to use a stage, just go to it, it's pretty safe, right? Like, I remember I sometimes go to my Burning Hideout, but I don't feel comfortable with that stage, right? And I think about it too much, and I think I lose more. Definitely respect that kind of the blade, I think, pulled from behind him and then hit forward, so he got so pulled him, like, into the spot. Cape is a popular tool for Quadrant a lot because you can confirm it into down tilt, up tilt, like that, right?
And you can cancel with this.
Yeah. I mean, the forward strong and up strong can do that, down strong can't do that, but you
down
don't
strong,
really
down strong.
Yeah,
so canceling a lot of people, you know, is something that,
yeah.
Anyway, probably
that might make him like really fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, get the hitbox. It's crazy because like that purple, and you know this is no possible way he could live, but that he was going so slowly.
Yeah.
What if he looks like?
Yeah. I love it though, because like purple feels kind of good, because at least you can go back on a set and say like, I couldn't have DI'd that anywhere, man. Like, I would. That was a crazy comeback from Unladen!
Yeah, damn, just as we were talking about.
I think that might have even been a zero to this. Possibly.
Oh,
my controls are there. Yeah, no, like, that was crazy. That was like, I think, down air to down air, and just hit the spike hitbox, and he couldn't recover because he was looking in the tank or the up air, so he crashed his jump. Crazy game.
Yeah, because he got back and went up. He jumped, and that got caught by the down. So when he up air, he didn't have the jump to get high enough.
DSR is coming into play.
Yeah, DSR coming into play, Unladen remembering that that was the game one stage.
Now, there is gentlemen's about DSR. Like, last grand finals we had between me and Aegis, we played every single set of Frozen game.
But of course, Unladen doesn't want to play that stage.
Yeah, exactly.
He goes to DSR. He can call that.
Well, because also, it's like, that's a very good stage for Clarence here. Because he crossed over.
Yeah, he got the damage. Crossing over zero. Now we
Unless I can play Battlefield, and now choose a rock wall. Sup, you guys here?
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, I just came by. I didn't come here for anything.
Okay. Okay.
Fair enough.
Anything to say?
Back to the match, rock wall. I think this might be good for both. So, I think the side blast zones are pretty good. Like, as in they're pretty small, right? So maybe Alistair might be able to get buffed here because a lot of what the kills that Alem goes for is off and off. Granted, yeah. And also, I think they can both probably use the side blast. I think Alistair likes to use the side blast here. Ooh, that was close. Trying to catch him on the other side. Wow, the falling down air. Yeah, no, that was definitely good fall out by him. Getting the down air. He also got the front header down there, so it didn't actually spike. The back header is the one that spikes. Good chance in this matchup. I've been appreciating a lot of ledge. Just been able to dodge. This high recovery was good. Good landing off from there. He's got full gas up. What will he try to do? Oh! If that had spiked, he would have gone to the neutral or down there. Definitely would have been a lot better. If Strong does take that stock though, that's kind of cool. Yeah, that was definitely the rock wall of last one. Especially here as well. Yeah, he would have died. Yeah, you're gonna die. Yeah. Unless you're like Volcano. Does get the down air. Oh, the punish scenario. Does not get out. What's going to happen here? They're both. Oh, actually, Alan Lennon has got a lot to play with right now since he's at 117. Second stock. Yeah. Oh, is that going to take it? Alan Lennon just forced, kind of forced an approach here. He's got the lead. He doesn't have to do a lot. Gets it down air. Going to look for the back air. Doesn't get it. He's got a ton of pressure on Lennon to do something like this. Ooh, the upshot takes it! One good interaction from Alistair could take it away, but also he's in the lead. And that air strong kill!
That is a reverse 3-0 from Unlimited to beat Alistair, who is down 2 over.
Well done to Unlimited moving up to Losers Finals.
Losers Finals! To play against ICK.
Yeah.
But, you know, whoever wins that match gets changing skins, winning games.
Is that the default skin you switched to?
No.
Oh, right.
Of course, he swapped skins and it worked out.
Oh, my bad. Okay. Oh, yeah, no, you're right. That is default. Let me get my controller on quick.